Greetings in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I'm Ulysses Tuff, Apostle and Pastor of the Way to Truth and the Life Christian Center. I would like to share my meeting on how I met Pastor Sundy, and it was in 1993. I was a part of a conference in New Moscow where we had brought 1,500 persons together to train them, to develop them. And in the process of that meeting, I had several interpreters, and it just so happened those interpreters were not properly fluent with my style of ministry. So I made a request for someone else, and I was informed at the time there was this young man who was just passing through, who, if I would like to try him, I could. So I said to the host, well, I don't have anything to lose, so I will try him. And of course, at the time, when I began to minister with this young man who is Sundy, things flowed so well. And of course, I was very thankful, and from my understanding, he departed, and I didn't see him again until 2 years later. Now, in 1995, I received a letter from him sharing with me what God had placed in his heart about a father in the Lord and what I consider being his father in the Lord. And I told him I would pray and I would come. Well, as time progressed from 1995 until now, the church itself at the time, and I would like to say this, in 1995, was very young. He was trying to develop and organize a number of things. So I came over to give support, and giving support, I had no agenda. I just wanted to help. And so I continued to come 3 or 4 times a year. To help to establish, to organize, and put structure in, and put a foundation for his personal walk in terms of things of faith, the spiritual gifts, so forth and so on. Well, as time began to progress, and of course now he's growing, the church is growing, and I would constantly come, and as I would come, it was most interesting because things got to be very, very intense, by the way, very, very intense in terms of the country, in terms of so many things they were trying to do to him, trying to do against him, and things they didn't want to happen. Of course, my intent was to continue to come as long as I could. Then as things began to mellow out, if you would please, things began to now take off, where now he was able to operate much more independent of me. I would constantly keep in contact with him. It brings us to now, which is around 2011. And what's interesting, the kinds of things that's going on now in 2011 with the attacks, so forth and so on, it seemed to be much more intense now than it was when I first started coming in 1995. And I understand because in 1995, he was quite young. He was not as much of a threat, but he was still a threat because there were threats on his life. There were a lot of things that was taking place. And these conferences have been good because they have allowed the brothers and sisters in this country to be solidified in their faith, to be solidified in the God who is the God of the Bible. And so these conferences was reinforcing, not only the persecution was real, but it's in keeping with what happens to those who will take a stand for the Lord Jesus Christ and try to live a life that will represent his kingdom. And so we began to see that Christians were maturing and the Christians in the church were maturing. And as they continued to mature, the church continued to grow and expand. And even though there were a lot of harassing and things going forward, those harassing and things only served as a point to remind them that they were on a good track. Why? Because initially they were told that the more persecution you have, then you're obviously doing something right for the Lord. And in spite of what takes place, just continue to stand strong in what you know to be true. So we see now how the church has so spread and people everywhere are being affected by the message of the kingdom of God concerning this church and what he's doing. I would like to address how it has been yet beneficial for just people in general. People in general, I believe, in this country, because you have a person here who he doesn't have any motives. And I know this for a fact, he doesn't have any motives, he's not trying to, never have been trying to get anything personally for himself. I remember many years ago we were trying to tell him to get a house, but he didn't want a house because his concern was he didn't want people to misunderstand his motive. Well, now he has a house, but from what's interesting to me is he has this house to let anyone come in who wants to live, who wants to need help. And out of that, we began to see that there were still some concerns about the house, some concerns, but it was never personal. It was never something that he was doing for himself. So everything that's happening now is for the people in this nation. And I've seen how so many people, drug addicts, alcoholics, so many people are getting delivered and set free. And I have traveled extensively throughout the world, and I have never seen any programs anywhere that have benefited a country more than that which has taken place in Ukraine. So for the people of Ukraine, it is my prayer and my desire that you will come to a place where you begin to embrace him, because he's really a man who loves this country. He loves the leadership. He prays for the leadership. He's not trying to undermine nor do harm and hurt, but trying to help. That is the responsibility for every Christian, to do everything we can to make our community better, to make our state better, to make our government better, not trying to take over government, but to help as much as possible. So if you would please, along with so many of us, continue to pray that the Ukrainians will continue to bless you, continue to be blessed, and you will find yourselves being helped in so many ways, because all the programs they have, I've seen, are so beneficial for every man, every woman, every boy, every girl in this country. I thank you so much for allowing me to share with you, and I embrace your country. I love coming here, and I continue to pray for you and the leadership that all the things that's in your heart will come to pass. And may God bless you.